What's up, guys? Bibbobog back here with another Let's Play episode, and this one's a bit different. We're making a new character. I actually caught up to where we were in the last game already with this character. I'm just going through the face now so that you guys can see how I made it. And basically, I wasn't having fun with the last character. I don't like the incorporation of magic, really. It's just too much to deal with, and it kind of makes it a lot harder also. And I'd rather just play a sticks and stones, bare-bone type of assassin, which is basically the skills are going to consist of archery, one-handed, light armor, sneak, and speech. Also, smithing and enchanting eventually as well. So, I hope you guys are looking forward to this fresh start. I certainly am. I think it'll go a lot better. This character is obviously a female red guard. Her name is Fall, as you'll see in just a moment here. And I'm going to jump into the backstory as soon as I finish typing in this name. I'll be joining you with gameplay, however, or at least I'll be playing the game. It won't really be gameplay. I'll just be standing there. Anyway, see you there. Alright guys, so we got our character here. This is the new one. She's all decked out in her copper circlet and her fur armor. I got a hunting bow on. Pretty basic stuff, but yeah, we're going to improve it. So here's the backstory. Fall was born into a large family of Red Guards in Hammerfell. She was the third child of five, and as much as her parents loved her, she was often forgotten amongst the others. She was intelligent and talented, however the same could be said about the rest of her siblings, and so she did not stick out for any particular reason. Fall learned quickly to tolerate this, as many of her siblings did, as she saw no other option. One thing that Fall did enjoy about having four siblings was that she was exposed to many different unique talents through her siblings. She would often observe her siblings' efforts at a particular skill, such as archery or alchemy, then would go off and practice it on her own. When it came time for Fall to leave home, she was already quite talented in many skills. She had learned to create potions from her eldest sister, Soika. She had learned to wield a bow with her younger brother, Amar. Her brother, Penlod, had taught her to wield a blade. She had learned to get around silently from her youngest, smallest, and admittedly favorite sibling, Alita. She had been taught to smith by her father and to enchant her gear by her mother. And finally, as with the rest of the family, she was equipped from head to toe in light armor. She left home prepared for anything, headed in the direction of Skyrim, where her older sister had settled down and opened an apothecary a couple of years earlier. On her way across the border to Skyrim, however, she was caught by a gang of Imperial soldiers and was brought to an execution at Helgen.
Alright, I'd say we're off to a pretty good start. I just totally recorded 5 minutes of this Let's Play and forgot to check the commentary box, so that's nice. So, yeah, one thing that I'm going to mention now is that all the skills that I mentioned in the backstory were, of course, in this backstory, or in this character, rather. And also, one that I failed to mention was speech, but I didn't really want to just say someone taught her speech, because that'd be weird. Anyway, I'll give us a look at the skill tree right now. So we got 1 into sneak, just 1 point into stealth, and we have 1 point into the light armor agile defender perk, we have 1 point into overdraw, and we got 1 into armsman, and also 1 into fighting stance in the one-handed tree. Other than that, I got a perk in enchanting, and that's just enchanter. I need to put 1 into alchemy next. But beyond that, we have 1 in speech, just the haggling perk. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and join the companions, because as we can see here, right here, it's actually on my miscellaneous quests, so I figure why not. And also, we won't be doing the Dark Brotherhood in this Let's Play, so I figure we need to do one of the guilds to start it off the bat, and this has gotta be the one. I mean, I don't really need enchanted gear since I'm going to into enchanting on my own. And one thing I will say, we are on expert difficulty this time through, so it should be a lot easier. It's going to be a nice transition from all that magey stuff. I'm really not as big a fan of that as I thought I was. It's really just easier to play without it. This is the original character that I played through the game with, except I didn't have a dagger on my original character because I didn't really know the perks all that well, which kind of reminds me of how I played Fallout 4, my first playthrough, which I just finished the other day. And I will be bringing a Let's Play to you guys of that pretty soon here, but I just gotta find somewhere where I can upload it because my internet cannot support 2 Let's Play uploads of an hour long each day. I'm gonna talk over these guys because, well, I mean, it's pretty old stuff, but I'd like to join the companions first off.
Would you now? Here,
Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and throw dialogue subtitles on. As you can see, we have the HUD on. I don't know if I mentioned that, because I did just talk to myself for 5 minutes. Anyway, I'm gonna throw that on, and I'm actually going to turn the voice volume down a little bit, just so I can make sure that I'm above them. That's alright, actually, where it's at. But I am going to talk over them, because I've seen this so many times, and I just don't want to listen to it again. I won't do that with Fallout 4, though, because it's all new to me,
or
at least just the second time.
Last I checked, we had some empty beds in Yorvaskar for those with a fire burning in their hearts.
I don't always have something to say over them, but sometimes it's interesting, I don't know. We'll play it by ear. If you guys don't like me talking over it in this episode, I will refrain from doing that in the next. It's just one of those things where it's kind of overdone.
It makes no difference.
I don't know.
What matters is their heart.
I assume that most of you who are watching this have seen this played before or played it yourself.
How are you in battle, girl?
I can handle myself.
That may be so. This is Vilkas. He will test your arm. Vilkas, take her out to the yard.
I think that the companions, ow, my ear is ringing, is a pretty good early game guild to join anyway, because of all the Draugr crypts you go into. It's a pretty easy way to level up, especially for stealth characters. If you didn't know that yourself, definitely look into it. You just pull out your sword or your dagger if you're already that high in sneak, and you just beat up a sleeping Draugr. It's pretty great. Pretty great. I haven't entirely decided what I'm going to do with this character. I am probably just going to play it the normal way I play it. I'm not going to put role-playing rules on the character, like no fast travel and the HUD anymore. I think that would have been a really cool idea, and I'd still love to do that at some point, but I think with this character, since it's just my first Let's Play that I'm really going to complete, hopefully, I'm going to put up probably only one episode a week, though, but we probably got 2 years before Elder Scrolls 6 comes out, which is sad, but that's at least 100 episodes, and if not, you know, we got 50 episodes instead, so we'll see. We'll get there, though, and I think 50 hours is still a lot to put up on one game, so it should get us through a good chunk of it. I'm gonna wait out here for this dude to show up, and I gotta pull these out anyway. I do have the scimitars.
The old man said to have a look at you, so let's do this.
That
just
I got from
have
that
a few
quest.
Swings at me so I can see.
Alright. Alright, let's go. I don't know when to stop hitting him. Sometimes you hit him too much, so and then he just
you
keeps hitting you. And
make
you never know if he's
but
actually gonna
now,
be pissed, so.
You're still a whelp to us, new blood. So you do what we tell you. Here's my sword. Go take it up to Yorland to have it sharpened. And be careful. It's probably worth more than you are.
Alright, well, that was rude and unnecessary, but let's continue along. So, another thing about this character, another reason I would like to join the companions, and I was talking about this in the 5 minutes that you'll never see, because it wasn't recorded, apparently. I would like to become a werewolf with this character, and I'd like to go down the werewolf perk tree, because I've never done that before. I never really went down Vampire Lord either, but that's okay. I went a ways into it. Anyway, Vilkas sent me with his sword.
I'm guessing you're the newcomer.
I just never maxed it out. I think I may have once, actually, but it was just on such a high difficulty that it didn't really do anything, and I'm just doing what I'm asked.
That attitude would get you far, if you were some stuffy merchant or a Jarl's footstool. Around here, you'll want to learn to live your own life. Remember, nobody rules anybody in the Companions.
Alright, I'll need to be going.
I have a favor to ask.
What is it?
I've been working on a shield for Aela. My wife is in mourning, and I need to get back to her soon. I'd be much obliged if you could take this to Aela for me.
Yeah, I could do that. I'm happy to lend a hand.
Well done.
Yeah, he says good man if you're a dude, but he doesn't know what to say if you're a female. So you may have been wondering why Redguard, and that's because I want that mask on my face when I use the Shrouded Cowl with a mask. And I just said we're not joining the Dark Brotherhood. What? I'm not even going to keep it a secret from you guys. You guys can be fully in on my plan because it's such a long ways off, because I have to be level 46 to do it, I think. And I'm going to take down the Dark Brotherhood because I've never done it before, and I think that'll be exciting.
Speak.
Also, I know I don't have to be level 46 to do it. I just want the Blade of Woe to be the best that it can. I may not even necessarily wait all that long. I mean, I'd like to, but I could also just craft and enchant my own gear. We'll see how that goes, how well we're going into smithing and enchanting as time goes on. But I will be still mining up some iron on this character, because we will be going into smithing, but I'll only really... Wow, you're mean. I don't like you. We'll probably really only be going into iron mines, or we'll only be mining iron at least. I won't need the
if
other
you wish
stuff
to hunt
because
with me,
I can make
your
gold
feet need
from
to
iron.
Be quick and your eyes quicker.
Alright, whatever. I have your shield. I don't know what you're talking about.
Ah, good. I've been waiting for this. Yes, wait, I remember you. You know, so the old man thinks you've got some heart, I guess. Slow.
You know this one? I saw her training in the yard with Vilkas.
Let's test that out sometime.
Ah, yes. You gave him
word gets around way too quickly here.
Don't let Vilkas catch you saying that.
Do you think you could handle Vilkas in a real fight?
Well, I don't care for boasting.
Ah, a woman who lets her actions speak for her. I knew there was something I liked about you. Here, let's have Farkas show you where you'll be resting your head.
All right.
Farkas.
I like this armor.
Call me?
It looks pretty good. It looks like a Pocahontas type character.
Show this new blood.
Because she looks Indian, not to be racist or anything. I mean, she's
new
a little
blood
dark for Native American Indian.
You.
But
come on, follow
I don't know,
me.
People in the comments, you never know on YouTube. I don't usually have that kind of stuff on my comments sections, thankfully. But as you get bigger,
Score
it begins
AL
to appear,
like
of course.
Me.
So
but they're good people.
We'll see if we get there one day.
They challenge
That's
us
an
to
odd
be our
goal
best
to have for a channel, but I'm gonna set it as one.
Nice to
you
have a new face
right
around.
At like,
it gets boring here
I don't
sometimes
even know. This is 9 minutes on top of whatever
you
I made in
this
iMovie.
This could be a rough life.
It's probably around 10,
the quarters
12
are up
minutes
here
in somewhere.
Just pick
in
a
there,
bed
maybe
and fall
I don't
in
know
it when you're tired. Tell me we'll keep the place
I want
clean
this bed.
I haven't
I
seen
want this bed.
Before, have
I want this bed.
Have we met?
I want this bed. Alright, I can't have any beds. All that's
right,
too bad.
So here you are. Looks like the others are eager to meet you.
Do I actually not have a bed at all? That's too bad, man.
Once you made a bit of a name for yourself, Skjor and Vilkas might have things for you to do.
I think you
good
have to
luck
do a couple quests.
Welcome to the
and
companions
then you could sleep in any bed, maybe. I don't know.
By the way, if you're looking for something to do, we've got trouble right here in Whiterun Hold. Nothing we can't handle.
Yeah, what kind of trouble should I expect?
Bloodsuckers. Vampires. Take every precaution. One bite and you could end up as one of them.
I'll take care of it.
Good. Do not spare them your blade.
Alright, I'm probably gonna
By
use my
way,
bow, but
if you're looking for something to do.
What are you talking about? You just gave me something to do. Alright. Broken Fang Cave. Oh, Whiterun Hold. Okay, I was gonna say, why would there be one in Whiterun? And I was kinda curious about that, but no, it's just the whole hold. That's alright, we'll get him. This'll be A-okay, I think. A little easy mission. I don't know, vampires are pretty tough, especially for level 8, but expert difficulty is not too rough. I mean, adept is kind of easy, so I don't know, Fallout 4 was kind of tough. I played a lot of that game on normal, and I didn't really go up. I played a little bit on easy, even, at some points. I don't think they have an expert, I think they just have, like, a hard, and then, like, the legendary equivalent of whatever Fallout is. I never actually looked at that. Yeah, anyway, I don't know where to go with my train of thought from here. I think we're going to spend a little bit more time than people would like in like areas where we're going to be enchanting things and making alchemy potions. I can cut some of that and mining and stuff like that. If you'd like to see it, feel free. I really don't know what to include in this as it is so late. I mean, normally early on you'd kind of cut all that so you can get the exciting stuff in, but now, you know, and then again, you don't want to see the same old stuff over and over, but who knows, who knows. So feel free to leave that in the comments if you would. I know it's a little bit late in the video to be asking for comment stuff, and I know it's only like 10, 12 minutes out of an hour video, but I don't think all that many people watch all the way through. I'm not entirely sure though. Most people watch all the way through builds, which I don't see why you wouldn't. But, oh, hello. Got some wolves. I need to get the soul trap enchantment. I actually did. And I put that enchantment on my bow. I forgot about that. Oh my goodness, there's a dragon. Okay, I'm gonna loot this and this. One thing about this character is that I'm not using any restoration. And, I don't know, we'll see what that does for us, but Jeez. It's for a role-playing purpose. I think it'll work out alright. Since we're going into alchemy, I just gotta make a few more health potions than I ever have, because I don't make health potions, because I don't make potions, but it's new to it's good to try new things. I would imagine that it would be quite fun to do some of that stuff in this game, since I haven't done it yet, so hopefully it's gonna be what I envisioned it to be. I don't know how much archery we're gonna be doing in third person, because I don't really like third person archery, but we'll see. I'm really hoping that dragon's not still out there when we go out there, because that would be just awful. But we'll see. Alright. There's enemies nearby, so I can't wait in there. I don't know how Marty detected, though. That's a little curious. I don't know. I don't think that's the right word. Hopefully I get sneak attacked. Yeah, there we go. Oh, no. Alright. So they're pretty powerful. Pretty healthy. I've contracted that shit, so I'll have to deal with that when I get back to Whiterun. Oh no. I didn't really have many health potions, so I'm concentrating. I'm not very good at that. We're gonna have to head out. This is a little annoying, I know. I'm sorry, I should cut this, but I'm gonna wait outside and then go back in with health, and yeah, actually let's pick this, because why not? We could use some alchemy stuff. I'm imagining that this vampire will have all of its health back, and that's probably not going to change our outcome of this battle at all. I mean, it'll probably be the same as it were before, I guess. I'm trying to say, I really don't know. Yeah, she's got full health again, though. And, shucks. Alright, as long as I keep my distance, she can't really do all that much damage. I mean, she is gaining her health back, which is crap, but if she gets up close, she can destroy me with her blade, so I don't know where to go from here. And I think I should take out the skeleton before he destroys me here, which he kind of started to. There's our first soul. I actually enchanted something already. I think it was a sword that I already got rid of, though, actually. So, never mind. I don't know for sure. Oh, come on. I had her, too. Dry mortal. Okay. There she goes. Oh, come on now. Knock that off. Oh, two kill cams that weren't proper kills. That's disappointing. Is she, like, waking this dude up? Yep. Waking up the master vampire. This is ridiculous. I'm gonna cut this. Alright, there go a couple of minutes, but this guy's pacing here, and I don't know what I meant by that. That was terribly phrased. But I think I'm gonna get wrecked if I try and attack both of these guys. And, yeah, sneak went up though, so that's good. And, yeah, here's both of these guys. Oh my goodness. Alright, yeah, no. Not at all. If I can just get to her, I think I can take out the guy. Although I don't have any sneak perks yet. I should once I level up here. I'll definitely invest some into there, but I'd like to use the one-handed does 3x sneak attack damage, for instance. That'd be a great help here. And she better not get over here with that blade, because that is a serious threat to my health. This is a good way of leveling, though. I like it. Only like 4 different times I had to wait. And no bad shot. No bad shot. Oh, come on now. That just stinks. I gotta get a shot on her now. Alright, the master should be coming in. And, there she is, maybe? I don't know. Yeah, got her. Awesome. Okay, now, the trick is getting this guy down to, nothing, which I don't see happening. Alright, we got one dead. I'm gonna wait. Alas, to Skyrim! This has got to be the weirdest Let's Play. Alright, let's loot this, actually. It's been sitting here for a while. Ooh, we got some decent stuff. I think the entire tone of this battle depends on whether I can get a sneak attack off on this guy, and he should be sleeping in the other room, I'm really hoping, because that would be very good. I don't think I'm going to be able to get up close enough to get a one-handed sneak attack off on him, and also I just don't have the perk, so it wouldn't be all that great anyway. I'm going to try and shoot him, and see how many shots I can get off before I had to pull out my swords. That sucks, I missed one. Two. Damn it, I'm done. I'm so done. Gun City, alright. I don't know if any of you actually watched that Until Dawn Let's Play, but that was a little reference there that has been stuck in my head for months, and I still use it, like, every day. The Gun City thing, so I don't know. Hopefully I can get this guy. I don't see any manageable way for me to do that at this point, but I could try archery. What we got? Alright, maybe this is the way we take him out. This is better than going back and forth. Watch him hit me with some spell right when I'm about to take him out too. It's coming. I can sense it. No? Alright, he's done. Fantastic. What can you do? It's a cheap enemy, cheap tactics work. People are dumb, I guess, you know? People do things like this all the time. I already used pretty much all of the enchantment on this bow, but I could just make a new enchantment. That'd be sweet. We got some vampire armor here. We might as well throw that on. I mean, let's see what it is in comparison to our armor right now. We got 31 and 7. And we got 34 and 34. I gotta disenchant that. I actually kinda like the armor we got on right now. It looks pretty good, so I'm gonna stick with it for the time being. Although I'll change it up pretty soon here, because obviously I want to succeed. It's just not all that much of an armor rating for that awesome look. And looks are more important than effectiveness to me in this character, at least as far as armor goes. Not so much weapons, but actually to a certain degree weapons. Like, I would never use a mace, although it would be a better stealth weapon than a sword, I'd imagine, because of the damage. Anyhow, we gotta go up here, because we have to go to the Talos statue so we can clear our vampirism. Hopefully I didn't wait too long to do that. I would imagine that we could do it, but we'll see. Getting pretty close to level 9. I don't know how far I am into this episode at this point, because I've separated them into a bunch of different little things, but I can't imagine we're too far in, so got quite a ways to go. I won't do any more 45-minute episodes like I did the last one, most likely, unless quests end up working out to be like that. I think that'll be the lowest I'd cut a video, is around 40 minutes, and the longest I'd probably go is hopefully around a minute and an hour and 10 minutes, rather. So let's activate that and see what our active effects are. I forgot about Adrenaline Rush. Alright, we're good. We should actually activate that instead of Unrelenting Force. I don't really like Unrelenting Force all that much. Adrenaline Rush is really good for a character that's going to be using combat two-handed, like constant barrage attacks, but I think we can make good use out of it in early assassin mode, just as kind of our last effort once we get detected. It's not like a health regenning thing, which would be nice, but whatever.
Some people don't think I'm smart. Those people get my fist, but you, I like.
Thanks. I've taken care of the problem. How flattering, this guy. Jeez.
Another job well done.
Blushing.
Your payment is secure, and you have my thanks.
Awesome. 100 gold. Not too bad. I'm looking for work.
Skior was looking for you earlier.
All right. What does he want?
Don't know. He just said he needed to talk to you before you do anything else. I don't like making him angry, but there is some work for you if you want it.
Yeah, I think I'll just take off and just leave. Talk to him later.
Pretend you didn't. Is it not allowed?
There you are.
You wanted to see me.
Not exactly forbidden, but even so, it's
not true. I did. Your time, it seems, has come.
I'm more curious about their conversation. What do you mean?
Last week, a scholar came to us. He said he knew where we could find another fragment of Wuthrad.
A scholar?
He seemed a fool to me.
I gotta make that build.
He's right. The honor of the companions demand that we seek it out.
So I'm going to listen to some of what they say, because it's easier than talking sometimes, but I'm really hungry. I'm just going to talk over them when I feel like it, unless you guys have any objections, so I'd be honored to retrieve it.
There's a fine line between respect and bootlicking, new blood. But I like your spirit.
You can't win with these guys. You just can't win.
Do well, and you'll be counted among the companions. Farkas will be your shield sibling on this venture. Well, he'll answer any questions you have. Try not to disappoint, or to get him killed.
I think it's really sexist that they didn't make husbands for this game. I've never actually gotten a wife in this game, which is something that we should totally do in this Let's Play. Gay marriage all the way. Just kidding. I think it'd just be fun to do because I haven't done it. Anyway, I'm not against gay marriage either. I don't know why I say things like that. I just get myself stuck between a rock and a hard place. Anyway, yeah, you're going to be my shield brother?
So I'm told. Let's see if you impress.
Anyway, I think you can, I think you can have either male or female, like, not spouses, or I don't even know. I think you can flirt with both genders in a Fallout before. It may depend on what gender you are. I really don't know. Can you train me to use Betty Harvey? No, I don't. I want to go to this location. All right, so we're going to travel to the Fort Greymoor first, and I don't think we're going to take this place out. This may be one that's not dealt with yet, but we're going to go ahead and do the objective. We'll deal with all this side stuff later. I may just go pretty deep into the companions to start off this Let's Play. I don't know. Let's see. Leave in the comments, you know? Can always go back to the main quest pretty soon here, too, just to get a few more shouts. Wouldn't mind that at all. Like, become ethereal. And at some point, we can get the rest of the become ethereal shouts and the Aura Whisper shouts and so on. So, yeah, pretty pumped for this Let's Play right now. And I just need to play this game to have fun. It's one of those things where if I'm not playing it, I'm like, I don't really want to play Skyrim because I've played so much. But when I'm playing it, I really enjoy it, so. Alright, come here, butterfly. Blue butterflies are very valuable in this, if you did not know. I'll get into that in a little bit, but where'd that other butterfly go? I don't care, you're not a valuable butterfly. Anyway, let's get going. I'll invest into alchemy with some of my next perks, but... or with one of my next few perks, I guess, rather. However, right now I want to go ahead and take care of some archery perks that definitely need some dealing with. Because that would be more of a pertinent, I believe, is a proper word to use here. I don't know what the follow-up word is that I need, but I know pertinent. Anyway, there appear to be some of these guys here. Awesome. No way you detected me that quickly, you mud crab. You silly mud crab, you. I'll take your soul. How about that? Alright, what do you got? Garnet? Ooh, that's pretty good. And it's shitting. I'll take some mud crab legs. I'll restore a little bit of health. Pretty much no health whatsoever, but... I've been actually picking up food in this game because I didn't do that in the past either, but it's one of those things where you're like, shoot. Maybe one health is worth it, you know? I mean, it's not, but it could be. Whereas in Fallout 4, food is much more useful because you got one other source of getting health because you don't have restoration or anything, so... You know, I think they balance it out quite well. I'm pretty excited for Elder Scrolls 6, though. I'm kind of disappointed that it wasn't where Fallout 4 was, of course, but Fallout 4 is a ton of fun. It's the first Fallout I've played, and I'm pretty excited for that reason, but... Other than that, it's not all too exciting. Alright, these guys bailed. I really don't need their... need to kill them that badly anyway. I don't know why we have to be hunting random animals. Maybe it's because we look like a badass hunter, and this game's all about killing things, but we'll see. We'll see. I don't know what we'll see means. They took off that way, but I could still get him, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, I thought we'd have to be a little bit higher. Did we get him? Alright, I'm gonna shoot one more arrow. That deer wasn't meant to be killed then. That's my ideology there. I don't know how much you have to adjust the aiming in this, because to a lot of a degree, you don't have to change the aiming in this for most shots, even if they're very far away. But I thought there was a chest here. I guess I was mistaken. We'll head down in here where I know there's a chest in here. It's got like a novice lock on it, but whatever. I really like the lock picking system in Fallout 4, except I don't like it at all. I pretty much didn't go into perks in Fallout 4 when I first started going into it for like the first 20 levels. I just went into special, which was pretty stupid. I got a couple perks, but not too many. I was kind of doing it so that I could have my builds more specialized, but I realized that it doesn't really matter the higher I go in that. We'll cross that bridge when we come to it, but anyway. Yeah, certainly does. Anyway, I like the lockpicking system because they make you get a perk to be able to unlock certain locks. And I didn't really go into it, so that's why I wasn't a huge fan of it, obviously, while I was playing the game, but I really liked the idea behind it. I was just lazy for not going into it because I didn't have proper perk management, but it was the first of those games that I played. Also, I do know that it was a little bit of a different format to the whole special thing than it was in Fallout New Vegas and Fallout 3 and all those games. So I don't know how much of it I would have messed up anyway if I were playing, having played Fallout prior to that. Anyway, I'm really bad at conversating when I'm killing things because I don't even know why. This is a pretty trivial task. But something about it makes you concentrate way too hard. Alright, I think his ancient Nordic bow will actually be better than this hunting bow, like for certain. I'm not for certain about that, but I'm pretty sure. I don't know why I didn't pick one up in the Bleak Falls Barrow prior to this, though, is my only concern about it. Although, it does do 11 damage, and my weapon does... Oh. What? Okay, I already had one of those. Alright, I did pick it up. And it's just... That's what I enchanted to. It wasn't the sword. That's such a mystery solver. Alright, basically I chose this one even though it's weaker because I bought it and it had Soul Trap. I didn't find it with Soul Trap. That's right. It all comes together now. Alright. Let's continue along here. This part is an annoyance because it just wastes time because I've seen it all before, but oh well. Let's grab this and let's do some enchanting. Why not, since it's here? What do we got? Let's disenchant. Not the soul snares. Destruction, dwindling, whatever. It is about dead, but my ancient Nord bow, I can get another one in a minute, but it does have an enchantment on it, so there's no real point. I'm gonna enchant my scimitars with some frost damage. And actually, I'd like you to just do 1 point of frost damage for a lot of hits. No, 2 points. I don't know. Why not? No. They're petty souls. I'll just have them do, like, 2 damage. That's a pretty good amount of damage, I'd say. And then this one lasts... Okay, it lasts the same amount. I guess I filled that common soul with a lesser soul. Or the common soul gem with a lesser soul. Anyhow. What else I got in here? I got this that I could put archery on, which would be sweet. Bows do 1% more damage. Yes, of course. What else could I possibly want? You get to see me with putting these wonderful enchantments on my gear. So, actually, you know what? I don't even want light armor. I'll take fortify stamina by 2 points. Yes. Alright. That probably was far less beneficial, but I do what I do sometimes, you know? Let's get fortify stamina. 2 points. What's up? And for bracers, we could get some archery on those. Sweet. And our last enchantment is going to be one of these necklaces or rings. Let's just go with some more fortify archery. And I'll make sure that that's the one that I'm wearing when I go into my apparel here. There we go. Awesome. Now, with this level up here, we're almost there, so you know what, I'll go into archery first, but then I'll go into alchemy next. Actually, I want to go into speech, or not speech, into sneak also. So we're gonna have to do some perk management. I really want to spread out my perks early game though. I don't want to be too far invested into one thing, because I will be going legendary in all of these skills eventually anyway, so I'd like to level them up all at a similar rate. I don't want to just go legendary in one thing 8 times, because it's easier that way for whatever reason. You know, it's one of those things. I don't know. We'll see. We shall see. I'd eventually like to set the goal of just getting all
now
the perks and all the trees
into.
That I've set
no worries,
up so far.
Just sit tight. I'll find the release.
Of course, with the exceptions of smithing and enchanting, eventually I could just return those perks from the black book at the end of the Dragonborn DLC, so I get to watch this guy die real quick, and I get to fight the rest of the dungeon on my own after these guys shoot me through the bars, which is nice. No, totally kidding. Obviously, you guys have seen this before, right? I'd imagine. Very hungry, but I'll deal with that in a minute, or I guess like 30 minutes. Probably less. Who knows? I'll check that out in a bit. Those guys were dying before he was even touching them. That's a powerful mofo right there. That just terrified him to death somehow. It's great. Alright. Okay, people are here. I'm gonna cut real quick. Alright.
I hope I didn't scare you.
I just took a good 40 minutes off, but I apologize for that small cut. Anyway, what was that?
It's a blessing given to some of us. We can be like wild beasts. Fearsome.
Badass. Can I be a werewolf?
Oh no. Only the Circle have the beast blood. Prove your honor to be a companion. Eyes on the prey, not the horizon. We should keep moving.
I like that.
Still the Draugr to
worry
about.
Eyes on the prey, but not the horizon. It's very wise. I hope they bring the looting system that they have in Fallout 4 into Elder Scrolls 6, because it's quite good, if I do say so myself. And it's nice to have those cure disease potions on us. I hope to load up on potions in this particular game. This save file, I guess. I don't know. Whatever the case. I think we're coming up on a little bit of an enemy here. One of these guys. It's the other chick, I think. This dude. Yeah, he's got a lot more health.
Watch it there.
I'm sorry, Farkas. I didn't mean to.
Watch it there, sister.
I didn't mean to. Stop getting in my way. Yeah, right through the arm. Nice. Farkas's arm, that was. Anyway, take this flawless amethyst and be on my way. I didn't really mention what the Fallout 4 looting system was, and basically what it is it just pops up whenever you go over their body, it just pops up all the items in their inventory, which is quite cool. I like it quite a bit. And, not yet, because I think this is... Oh, yeah, here we go. Autosave, why not? I think there's some trouble brewing nearby. But this is the first spot where you can just get some sneak increase to 32 there. There we go. I'm going to go into Alchemy because if I don't do it now, I won't do it later. And I'm going to stop going into health once we get to 200 as well to go into stamina for just a bit. And then I'll go back into health because that's the great thing about an assassin is that you can go into health. And whereas with a mage assassin, I like to just go into magic. Because assassins aren't supposed to be detected anyway. Why would you ever get hit? No, early game, it's a very useful thing to have. Alright, I'm glad he didn't hit me. It totally looked like he was gonna. Alright, here we go. Some Horger loaf that's probably not worth it in the weight to usefulness ratio, but oh well. Alright. You're done in 7 arrows from now. This guy's just straight up missing me. I'm not even straight. I figured I had a pretty good amount of health. And I didn't want to waste any... Well, I didn't want to mess up my aim on him, and I don't know why that was a sneak attack. That's quite clutch. Yeah, let's see what we got in this chest here. Got some arrows and amethyst and some gold. Not too shabby. I was gonna say not too bad, but I don't know. Something happened there. Anyway, there's a master lock over here that I wish I could open, but obviously that's not gonna be an option. Let's see what this guy's got, and 1 second, I just gotta cut real quick. Alright, my apologies for that. That's actually not a bad solution. I was trying to text someone, and then I was gonna be like, hey, you gotta go away, but they don't respond very often anyway, so I could just mini cut like that, and as long as we're not in combat, it'll be all good. I hope you guys don't mind that. I don't think you would. Doesn't affect you too much. As I cut, so you know, that's that. Alright, let's see. Here is a really good place to get some extra stealth bonus. There's a nice Draugr dead. And you gotta wait for this eye to go entirely away each time you do it. Otherwise, you won't get the sneak attack bonus. And every time you attack someone, I believe that it is guaranteed that that eye will pop open just from your companion. But I'm not certain. Anyhow, I'm gonna do double armed attacks on the rest of these guys, because I don't know how many of them are just Draugr, and if any of them are Restless Draugr or anything like that. There is a much more threatening enemy right up close to here. However, I think I can take this guy out first. I don't know where they are. Oh, there they are. Alright. I'm just gonna pull out my bow and let Farkas do most of the work. In the past, I've tried to do this on experts, and it hasn't worked out too well. Simply because he just wrecks Farkas like he is right now. And then he comes back to me, and yeah, it's pretty evident that I won't be surviving this unless I get some hits off. So we are only on expert though. It didn't do too bad of a chunk of damage there. It usually does a bit more if you're running. But then again, I am used to playing on master. I don't know why I kept saying expert, if that's what I'm saying. Anyway, my apologies there, and let's move on, because that guy was not this guy, and this guy is still alive, so we might as well take out this guy. Fantastic. Alright, let's get into third person so we look cool, and I got to cut real quick. Sorry. Alright, right back, and I'm not certain of where. I was pretty sure that there was some Draugr here, but I guess not. I don't know where that train of thought was exactly going. I kind of started speaking before the thought came into mind. However, it just seemed like there should have been a few more Draugr right there, and I actually gotta cut in a minute here anyway, just to check. I haven't checked how long the episode's been at for a while, but I'll clear out this next area before we do that, because I don't want to excessively do that. I've already done it a couple times in a couple minutes, and that's no good, right? Alright. Let's see what we got. I forgot about the aim perk that I now have, which is apparently not helpful. No, it's actually a really helpful perk, but
time to end this.
Okay. Light arm is going up, that's good. I don't have any health potions. No, I picked up a few health potions. So that's good. We can use those. There we go. There's a nice, I don't even know, just barrage of attacks. I don't know what to call it. Sometimes it doesn't always pop up, even if you have a tiny bit of stamina. It just does the one that attacked before then, where it's just like that. But whatever. Anyway, as you can see, it used up a little bit of stamina, right? Nope. Alright, I guess not. I'm tripping. I think that kind of cleared out this area, so we should be headed through the next. Oh, pretty soon here. This part could be a little tough. Yeah, can't wait here, but I guess we'll just have to go in with a little less than full health. And hopefully we can get a couple sneak shots off on her. Nope, not the case. Not even close to the case. Alright. That was painful, a little bit. I got some resistant poison in my blood because I'm a red guard, which is nice. I just missed all those almost. That sucks. Let's loot him, see what he's got. So we got some gold and not much else. Alright. Gonna go ahead and take her down now, and yeah, this is a lot easier on expert, I must say. I'm so used to the Fallout 4 method of looting that I keep expecting it to pop up without having to actually manually loot them. I may forget some chests in this because I've been forgetting to look around a lot in Fallout 4, and I'm just used to it. Anyway, I'm gonna cut this loading screen here. Alright, so I didn't realize until now that the game audio is actually a little bit on the loud side, so I apologize for that. I did turn it down a bit. I should have just stood back and shot that guy. I thought I heard him when I first walked through here. It must have been someone else. And that's not too invaluable, so we might as well take it with us. And actually, I don't need this bow for the next room. I actually need these swords. But it's good to sneak through here, because as you can see, there are some people fighting down here. And it looks like they're taking a shot up at maybe Vilkas? Farkas? Yeah, Farkas, whatever. They're brothers anyway, right? Says I'm undetected, so hopefully that's all that matters here. And hopefully we don't... Yeah, I was afraid that he would open up the eyeball partway through that attack. Alright, let's level up. Normally I save my level ups for combat anyway, but I might as well go into something here. We could go into lockpicking, but I've never gone into lockpicking before. It would be fun to do. I'd like to get a few of these essentials out of the way first before I do that, though. Like backstab. That's a good one to have early on. That'll increase our damage quite proficiently. And this is the area I was thinking of earlier when I was thinking there should be a Draugr. Anyway, he's done. And as you can see, it stops leveling sneak in one hit pretty quickly. It'll still be a level up right here, I think. Yeah, but it pretty quickly evens out. It seems a little power level-y, but I don't think it's too bad. If you disagree, then I can always change that method. But there's so many experts in this game that, you know, what's the better method of taking him out? Just letting him attack you? I don't know. Seems silly to me. We'll see what we can do, though. Hopefully this is to all of your liking, or however you'd like to say it. All right. I was not expecting that person to be right there, and so I didn't get off the best. Oh my goodness. Alright, I got scared because he was attacking that dude, and there was another dude, and I thought I was gonna die, so that's my apologies on the spaz attack right there, but we might as well loot this other corpse. 10 points of health, not bad. Not bad at all. I just gotta remember to use food. And I don't need to be wasting power attacks on dudes who are already at mercy level, but whatever, not mercy level. I don't know what I'm talking about at this point. I hope you guys are still watching, and I hope you enjoy. If you are, leave a comment. I've seen this on other channels before. It says banana, so I can know how far you've gone in. And we'll see if I get any bananas in the comments section. I'm gonna leave this up for like a week before I upload the next one anyway, though, so we'll see. Maybe we'll get one or two, hopefully. Yes, so... Alright, this is an adept level lock, I guess. That's not something to be messed with anymore. I'm so used to Fallout 4's adept level locks. They seem like novice locks with, What was that? I had it on the sweet spot, and then I didn't even move it, and it just... whatever. Alright, that should be enough. There we go. Jeez, I've gotten bad at lockpicking despite just spending a week or two. No, I haven't been lockpicking in Fallout 4 because I didn't have the perks, that's right. Yeah, I keep messing up the third person and sneak buttons too because I'm playing on PS4 for Fallout 4. And the Fallout 4 third person button is actually the touchpad, whatever it is called. I think it might just be called a touchpad. Anyhow. This guy don't see me? Alright, then he's off with his head. Read some Alice in Wonderland, yesterday, actually, because I got bored at my grandmother's birthday, and, what else am I gonna do at a grandma's birthday? Not read Alice in Wonderland? Yeah, right. Alright, I may be a weird person, but so are you. shots fired. Anyway, the skeever's done. If I could line this up properly. There's a nice kill cam. And, we got one more of him back here, and he's gonna see me. Alright, didn't make a difference. Should've got all the skeever tails, but whatever. It's not uberly important. Some of those things are just... going to the effort of looting them is just a bit much. I don't know. Like, while you're in combat, at least. In Fallout 4, what I tend to do is I'll just go through the whole area, and then I'll just re-go through the floor, after the combat's over to loot all the corpses. I actually want to make something real quick. Why not? Well, while the alchemy lab's here, so let's go with this, with that. Boom. Fantastic. We got some poisons, I believe. Not certain. That only leveled up twice? That's a little unfortunate. I thought it'd be a little bit more than that, seeing as how they're pretty expensive potions. If I'm not mistaken. Let me check it out. Yeah, potions are up here. Alright. 291, that's not bad. I'm gonna cut real quick, I'll be right back. And we're back, bet you didn't even notice I was gone. Where are we going? This is the wrong way, this is the right way. Here we go. Should we test out one of those poisons? I think there's a frost spider in this next room. I don't know if they'd be affected by poison, it's the only thing. And what is this skeever doing? That was crazy. He just teleported. I still don't know where he is. Whatever. Let's fight this spider instead. There we go. Nice sneak attack there. That guy's dead. This guy is resisting arrest, but we can deal with him subtly, I suppose. I don't know how that would be done. I'm using a bow, for Christ's sake. But... oh my goodness. Alright, so today, one of my friends showed me a picture of a gigantic fish about half the size of himself that he shot with a bow and arrow out of his river in his backyard, which is only like a foot deep. A lot of crazy stuff about that story. I'll allow you to soak those amendments to the story in piece by piece for a moment here while I suffer through this combat. Hopefully this guy will take on the archer. I can't really deal with him right now. He's done. Alright, fantastic. But there's still one more enemy lurking about. These guys got some stuff. You got some stuff too? Yeah, you got some stuff. Alright. Oh, I should pick up his bow, actually. That way I can make a better soul trap bow. And there's that dirty skeever who earlier on was glitching through the wall, I believe. If I'm not mistaken. Right up here should be another archer, maybe? I don't know. Maybe he was the one who came over. I didn't imagine that we triggered him already, but I guess we had. So we'll head into this next room instead. And I don't really have many health potions, so this is going to go horribly, I predict. But, yeah, let me, let's see. I think I can use those poisons on some of the big guys just to put them to use. Those are mostly just going to be used for getting our alchemy to level up, though. And, yeah, that should be good. Should be good. Alright. Grab this fragment and, this word wall here, which is fire breath. The first word for us, actually. And, let's grab this chest real quick. Not too much greatness, but, I love that chant. It's fantastic. And this cool-looking helmet. I actually like this steel-horned helmet. I'm gonna be right back, though. Alright, let's go deal with all these Draugr that are gonna spawn now. I'm not even gonna bother trying to sneak. I've never gone through this place stealthily, this dungeon before. I think it's just because the follower... I don't know if he even allows you to, but I haven't done the companions very late game ever. If I do, I might usually do them first for obvious reasons with the stealth upgrading and me not having... the Dark Brotherhood armor to rely on. It's very necessary for this let's play, I'd say. Because that stealth bonus is pretty much what gets me through the early game if I don't go with companions first. So, yeah. Gonna get our one-handed up a little bit here. I find that the one-handed skill is very difficult to upgrade later on in the game. Just because you use it so little, because you assassinate people with your dagger and it doesn't do very much damage. So unless you're using swords constantly, it's kind of hard to level them up. But when we go into smithing, I might make some swords, and we might just branch out from archery for certain, or from the blade, the dagger, whatever the case, for just a few missions, probably like the Civil War missions and stuff like that, just the full-scale battle stuff, and where we don't feel like being an assassin. But we'll see when we get there. I think that's a long ways off, so not too much to worry about there. Still got these guys spawning. I think now they're just... I guess not yet, even, but they should be getting to the Restless Draugr pretty soon here, which I'd imagine is the dude who just came out of that crypt. And I bet he can shout if you come here way later in the game. I'd imagine. I think I've played this later in the game. I just don't remember it. I'd imagine that I have, though, at least once, you know? I don't know. This was one of the first guilds that I ever discovered when I first started playing this game, though, because my cousin pointed me in the direction, because I hadn't played the game before obviously, and he was showing me around, but he did a poor job of that. He let me spec my skills terribly, and I ended up having to restart that character pretty early on. But I had a feel for it by the time that was over, so that was cool. And is this last one already out? Alright, yeah, so we're headed home. That song, you know, I'm never gonna sing a full verse, that's awful. I'm gonna cut, I'll be right back. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and turn this quest in and call it an episode, because I, if I counted properly, am somewhere around 56-ish minutes by now, I hope. I don't know, something like that. I'm gonna try and upload this here tonight, and I'll try to upload whatever else tomorrow, maybe, we'll see. I'm considering playing some Fallout 4, doing a Let's Play tonight, starting the episode. I also kinda wanna make a backstory that's part of me. I don't know if I'm gonna actually do that or not. But I think what I will be doing is I will certainly be going ahead and doing that at some point. I'm going to play some Fallout 4 regardless. I may play on my other character, but I got all the bobbleheads and I beat the game, and I'm not really sure what else I have to do on that game, but I obviously have to start making builds, so I think it's a little more important that I go ahead and start working on that instead of actually making a Let's Play, but whatever. We'll see. I'll eventually make both of them, obviously. I really don't know what I just said, which is terrible, but whatever. Yeah. I kind of ran out of things to say, and this loading screen is not being my friend right now, but I hope you're enjoying the companions, and, I know they're not my favorite either, but they're actually not too bad. I enjoy them. I just happen to enjoy probably the Nightingale best. That's probably the best questline. Behind that, the College, and then the Thieves Guild, and then the Dark Brotherhood. I'm not a huge fan of the Dark Brotherhood. I might actually like the Companions more than the Dark Brotherhood questline in general. It's just not too fun. You just go around and assassinate this person, go over here and assassinate that person. Who cares? Stupid. Not a fan. I like the dungeon crawling type stuff that you do, which obviously fits this quite well.
Brothers and sisters of the Circle, today we welcome a new soul into our mortal fold. This woman has endured, has challenged, and has shown her valor. Who will speak for her?
I stand witness to the courage of the soul before us.
I'm gonna let the ceremony play out.
Your shield.
I've been looking for you.
Defense.
Got something I'm supposed to deliver.
Stand at her
hands only.
The world.
And this courier would ruin the moment, wouldn't he?
Better for the Jarl. Moving up in the world, eh?
It stands ready.
Looks like that's it.
Blood of her
got
foes.
To go.
And would you raise a mug in her name?
I would lead the song of triumph as our mead hall reveled in her stories.
Then the judgment of this circle is complete. Her heart beats with fury and courage that have united the companions since the days of the distant green summer. Let it beat with ours.
This is pretty epic. I like this. I don't listen to this often.
Our enemies may tremble at the call.
God lacks a beast.
It shall be so. I've heard you may
well, girl, you're one of us now. I trust you won't disappoint.
Why, thank you. Oh, alright, you took that from me. Yeah, let's talk to this dude, though.
Some people don't think I'm smart.
We've
gotten a letter about someone needing some muscle right here in Whiterun Hold. I don't know what the fight is about, and that's not our business anyway. I just need you to go out there, look tough, and scare this milk drinker into submission. No more than that. I don't want to hear about a killing, understand?
I can handle that.
Get to it then.
Alright, so this is pretty cool, because this one's probably actually in Whiterun, which is a nice change of pace. Other times you go to places that are far away, and they have hard tasks, but not this time, and I really like the aesthetics of this character. The face looks a little weird from a distance, but she's actually not too bad up close, so hope you enjoyed, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace. Perk that I now have, which is apparently not helpful. Well, it's actually a really helpful perk, but...
Time to end this game.
Okay. Light arm is going up, that's good. I don't have any health potions. No, I picked up a few health potions. So that's good. We can use those. There we go. There's a nice... I don't even know, just barrage of attacks. I don't know what to call it. Sometimes... I don't know. It doesn't always pop up, even. you have a tiny bit of stamina, it just does the one that attacked before then, where it's just like that. But whatever. Anyway, as you can see, it used up a little bit of stamina, right? Nope. Alright, I guess not. I'm tripping. I think that kind of cleared out this area, so we should be headed through the next... Oh, pretty soon here. This part could be a little tough. Yeah, can't wait here, but I guess we'll just have to go in with a little less than full health. And hopefully we can get a couple sneak shots off on her. Nope, not the case. Not even close to case. Alright. That was painful, a little bit. I got some resistant poison in my blood because I'm a red guard, which is nice. I just missed all those, almost. That sucks. Let's loot him, see what he's got. So we got some gold and not much else. Alright. Gonna go ahead and take her down now. And, yeah. This is a lot easier on expert, I must say. I'm so used to the Fallout 4 method of looting that I keep expecting it to pop up without having to actually manually loot them. I may forget some chests in this because I've been forgetting to look around a lot in Fallout 4 and I'm just used to it. Anyway, I'm gonna cut this loading screen here. Alright, so I didn't realize until now that the game audio is actually a little bit on the loud side, so I apologize for that. I did turn it down a bit. I should have just stood back and shot that guy. I thought I heard him when I first walked through here. It must have been someone else. And that's not too invaluable, so we might as well take it with us. And actually, I don't need this bow for the next room. I actually need these swords. But it's good to sneak through here. Because as you can see, there are some people fighting down here. And it looks like they're taking a shot up at maybe Vilkas? Farkas? Yeah, Farkas, whatever. They're brothers anyway, right? It says I'm undetected, so hopefully that's all that matters here. And hopefully we don't... Yeah, I was afraid that he would open up the eyeball partway through that attack. Alright, let's level up. Normally I save my level ups for combat anyway, but I might as well go into something here. We could go into lockpicking, but I've never gone into lockpicking before. It would be fun to do. I'd like to get a few of these essentials out of the way first before I do that, though. Like backstab. That's a good one to have early on. That'll increase our damage quite proficiently. And this is the area I was thinking of earlier when I was thinking there should be a Draugr. Anyway, he's done. And as you can see, it stops leveling sneak in one hit pretty quickly. It'll still be a level up right here, I think. Yeah, but it pretty quickly evens out. It seems a little power level-y, but I don't think it's too bad. If you disagree, then I can always change that method. But there's so many experts in this game that... You know, what's the better method of taking him out? Just letting him attack you? I don't know. Seems silly to me. We'll see what we can do, though. Hopefully this is to all of your liking, or however you'd like to say it. Alright, I was not expecting that person to be right there, and so I didn't get off the best. Oh my goodness. Alright, I got scared because he was attacking that dude. And there was another dude, and I thought I was gonna die, so that's my apologies on the spaz attack right there, but we might as well loot this other corpse. 10 points of health, not bad. Not bad at all. I just gotta remember to use food. And I don't need to be wasting power attacks on dudes who are already at mercy level, but whatever, not mercy level. I don't know what I'm talking about at this point. I hope you guys are still watching, and I hope you enjoy. If you are, leave a comment. I've seen this on other channels before. It says banana, so I can know how far you've gone in. And we'll see if I get any bananas in the comments section. I'm gonna leave this up for like a week before I upload the next one anyway, though, so we'll see. Maybe we'll get one or two, hopefully. Yes, so... Alright, this is an adept level lock, I guess. That's not something to be messed with anymore. I'm so used to Fallout 4's adept level locks. They seem like novice locks with a... What was that? I had it on the sweet spot. And then I didn't even move it. And it just... Whatever. Alright, that should be enough. There we go. Jeez, I've gotten bad at lockpicking despite just spending a week or two. No, I haven't been lockpicking in Fallout 4 because I didn't have the perks. That's right. Yeah, I keep messing up the third person and sneak buttons too because I'm playing on PS4 for Fallout 4. And the Fallout 4 third person button is actually the touchpad, whatever it is called. I think it might just be called a touchpad. Anyhow. This guy don't see me? Alright, then he's off with his head. Read some Alice in Wonderland, yesterday, actually, because I got bored at my grandmother's birthday, and, what else am I gonna do at a grandma's birthday? Not read Alice in Wonderland? Yeah, right. Alright, I may be a weird person, but so are you. shots fired. Anyway, the skeever's done. If I could line this up properly. There's a nice kill cam. And, got one more of them back here, and he's gonna see me. Alright, didn't make a difference. Should've got all the skeever tails, but whatever. It's not uberly important. Some of those things are just... going to the effort of looting them is just a bit much. I don't know. Like, while you're in combat, at least. In Fallout 4, what I tend to do is I'll just go through the whole area, and then I'll just re-go through the floor, after the combat's over to loot all the corpses. I actually want to make something real quick. Why not? Well, while the alchemy lab's here. So let's go with this, with that. Boom. Fantastic. We got some poisons, I believe. Not certain. That only leveled up twice. That's a little unfortunate. I thought it'd be a little bit more than that, seeing as how they're pretty expensive potions. If I'm not mistaken. Let me check it out. Yeah, potions are up here. Alright. 291, that's not bad. I'm gonna cut real quick, I'll be right back. And we're back! Bet you didn't even notice I was gone. Where are we going? This is the wrong way, this is the right way. Here we go. Should we test out one of those poisons? I think there's a frost spider in this next room. I don't know if they'd be affected by poison, it's the only thing, and what is this skeever doing? That was crazy. He just teleported. I still don't know where he is. Whatever. Let's fight this spider instead. There we go. Nice sneak attack there. That guy's dead. This guy is, resisting arrest, but we can deal with him subtly, I suppose. I don't know how that would be done. I'm using a bow, for Christ's sake, but... Oh my goodness! Alright, so today, one of my friends showed me a picture of a gigantic fish about half the size of himself that he shot with a bow and arrow out of his river in his backyard, which is only like a foot deep. A lot of crazy stuff about that story. I'll allow you to soak those amendments to the story in piece by piece for a moment here while I suffer through this combat. Hopefully this guy will take on the archer. I can't really deal with him right now. He's done. Alright, fantastic. But there's still one more enemy that I can bout. This guy's got some stuff. You got some stuff too? Yeah, you got some stuff. Alright. Oh, I should pick up his bow, actually. That way I can make a better soul trap bow. And there's that dirty skeever, who earlier on was glitching through the wall, I believe. If I'm not mistaken. Right up here should be another archer, maybe? I don't know. Maybe he was the one who came over. I didn't imagine that we triggered him already, but I guess we had. So we'll head into this next room instead. And I don't really have many health potions, so this is going to go horribly, I predict. But, yeah, let me, let's see. I think I can use those poisons on some of the big guys just to put them to use. Those are mostly just going to be used for getting our alchemy to level up, though. And, yeah, that should be good. Should be good. Alright. Grab this fragment and, this word wall here, which is fire breath. The first word for us, actually. And, let's grab this chest real quick. Not too much greatness, but, I love that chant. It's fantastic. and this cool looking helmet. I actually like.
What's up guys, BitBobog back here with another Let's Play episode, and this one's a bit different. We're making a new character. I actually caught up to where we were in the last game already with this character. I'm just going through the face now so that you guys can see how I made it. And basically, I wasn't having fun with the last character. I don't like the incorporation of magic, really. It's just too much to deal with, and it kind of makes it a lot harder also. And I'd rather just play sticks and stones, bare-bone type of assassin, which is basically the skills are going to consist of archery, one-handed, light armor, sneak, and speech, also smithing and enchanting eventually as well. So I hope you guys are looking forward to this fresh start. I certainly am. I think it'll go a lot better. This character is obviously a female Redguard. Her name is Fall, as you'll see in just a moment here, and I'm going to jump into the backstory as soon as I finish typing in this name. I'll be joining you with gameplay, however, or at least I'll be playing the game. It won't really be gameplay. I'll just be standing there. Anyway, see you there. Alright guys, so we got our character here. This is the new one. She's all decked out in her copper circlet and her fur armor. I got a hunting bow on. Pretty basic stuff, but yeah, we're going to improve it. So here's the backstory. Fall was born into a large family of Redguards in Hammerfell. She was the third child of five, and as much as her parents loved her, she was often forgotten amongst the others. She was intelligent and talented, however the same could be said about the rest of her siblings, and so she did not stick out for any particular reason. Fall learned quickly to tolerate this, as many of her siblings did, as she saw no other option. One thing that Fall did enjoy about having four siblings was that she was exposed to many different unique talents through her siblings. She would often observe her siblings' efforts at a particular skill such as archery or alchemy, then would go off and practice it on her own. When it came time for Fall to leave home, she was already quite talented in many skills. She had learned to create potions from her eldest sister, Soika. She had learned to wield a bow with her younger brother, Amar. Her brother, Penlod, had taught her to wield a blade. She had learned to get around silently from her youngest, smallest, and admittedly favorite sibling, Alita. She had been taught to smith by her father and to enchant her gear by her mother. And finally, as with the rest of the family, she was equipped from head to toe in light armor. She left home prepared for anything, headed in the direction of Skyrim, where her older sister had settled down and opened an apothecary a couple of years earlier. On her way across the border to Skyrim, however, she was caught by a gang of Imperial soldiers and was brought to an execution at Helgen.
Alright, I'd say we're off to a pretty good start. I just totally recorded 5 minutes of this Let's Play and forgot to check the commentary box, so that's nice. So, yeah, one thing that I'm going to mention now is that all the skills that I mentioned in the backstory were, of course, in this backstory, or in this character, rather. And also, one that I failed to mention was speech, but I didn't really want to just say someone taught her speech, because that'd be weird. Anyway, I'll give us a look at the skill tree right now. So we got one into sneak, just 1 point into stealth, and we have 1 point into the light armor agile defender perk. We have 1 point into overdraw, and we got one into armsman, and also one into fighting stance in the one-handed tree. Other than that, I got a perk in enchanting, and that's just enchanter. I need to put one into alchemy next, but beyond that, we have one in speech, just the haggling perk. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and join the companions, because as we can see here, right here, it's actually on my miscellaneous quests, so I figure why not. And also, we won't be doing the Dark Brotherhood in this Let's Play, so I figure we need to do one of the guilds to start it off the bat, and this has got to be the one. I mean, I don't really need enchanted gear since I'm going to into enchanting on my own. And one thing I will say, we are on expert difficulty this time through, so it should be a lot easier. It's going to be a nice transition from all that magey stuff. I'm really not as big a fan of that as I thought I was. It's really just easier to play without it. This is the original character that I played through the game with. Except I didn't have a dagger on my original character, because I didn't really know the perks all that well. Which kind of reminds me of how I played Fallout 4, my first playthrough, which I just finished the other day. And I will be bringing a Let's Play to you guys of that pretty soon here, but I just gotta find somewhere where I can upload it, because my internet cannot support two Let's Play uploads of an hour long each day. I'm gonna talk over these guys, because, well, I mean, it's pretty old stuff, but I'd like to join the companions first off.
Would you now?
Here.
Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and throw dialogue subtitles on. As you can see, we have the HUD on. I don't know if I mentioned that, because I did just talk to myself for 5 minutes. Anyway, I'm gonna throw that on, and I'm actually going to turn the voice volume down a little bit, just so I can make sure that I'm above them. That's alright, actually, where it's at. But
perhaps
I am going to talk over them, because I've seen this so many times, and I just don't want to listen to it again. I won't do that with Fallout 4, though, because it's all new to me.
I am nobody's
master.
Or
at least just the second time.
Last I checked, we had some empty beds in Yorvasker for those with a fire burning in their hearts.
I don't always have something to say over them, but sometimes it's interesting. I don't know. We'll play it by ear. If you guys don't like me talking over it in this episode, I will refrain from doing that in the next.
Sometimes men and women,
it's just one of those things where it's kind of overdone.
It makes no difference.
I don't know.
What matters is their heart.
I assume that most of you who are watching this have seen this played before or played it yourself.
How are you in battle, girl?
I can handle myself.
That may be so. This is Vilkas. He will test your arm. Vilkas, take her out to the yard.
I think that the companions, ow, my ear is ringing, is a pretty good early game guild to join anyway, because of all the Draugr crypts you go into. It's a pretty easy way to level up, especially for stealth characters. If you didn't know that yourself, definitely look into it. You just pull out your sword or your dagger if you're already that high in sneak, and you just beat up a sleeping Draugr. It's pretty great. Pretty great. I haven't entirely decided what I'm going to do with this character. I am probably just going to play it the normal way I play it. I'm not going to put role-playing rules on the character, like no fast travel and the HUD anymore. I think that would have been a really cool idea, and I'd still love to do that at some point, but I think with this character, since it's just my first Let's Play that I'm really going to complete, hopefully, I'm going to put up probably only one episode a week, though, but we probably got 2 years before Elder Scrolls 6 comes out, which is sad, but that's at least 100 episodes, and if not, you know, we got 50 episodes instead, so we'll see. We'll get there, though, and I think 50 hours is still a lot to put up on one game, so it should get us through a good chunk of it. I'm gonna wait out here for this dude to show up, and I gotta pull these out anyway. I do have the scimitars.
The old man said to have a look at you, so let's do this.
That
just
I got from
have
that
a few
quest.
Swings at me so I can see.
Alright, let's go. I don't know when to stop hitting him. Sometimes you hit him too much, so and then he just
you
keeps hitting you. And you never know if he's
but
actually going
to
be pissed, so.
You're still a whelp to us, new blood. So you do what we tell you. Here's my sword. Go take it up to Yorland to have it sharpened. And be careful. It's probably worth more than you are.
Alright, well, that was rude and unnecessary, but let's continue along. So, another thing about this character, another reason I would like to join the companions, and I was talking about this in the 5 minutes that you'll never see, because it wasn't recorded, apparently. I would like to become a werewolf with this character, and I'd like to go down the werewolf perk tree, because I've never done that before. I never really went down vampire lord either, but that's okay. I went a ways into it. Anyway, Vilkas sent me with his sword.
I'm guessing you're the newcomer.
I just never maxed it out. I think I may have once, actually, but it was just on such a high difficulty that it didn't really do anything, and I'm just doing what I'm asked.
That attitude would get you far, if you are some stuffy merchant or a Jarl's footstool. Around here, you'll want to learn to live your own life. Remember, nobody rules anybody in the companions.
Alright, I'll need to be going.
I have a favor to ask.
What is it?
I've been working on a shield for Aela. My wife is in mourning, and I need to get back to her soon. I'd be much obliged if you could take this to Aela for me.
Yeah, I could do that. I'm happy to lend a hand.
Well done.
Yeah, he says good man if you're a dude, but he doesn't know what to say if you're a female. So you may have been wondering why Redguard, and that's because I want that mask on my face when I use the Shrouded Cowl with a mask, and I just said we're not joining the Dark Brotherhood. What? I'm not even gonna keep it a secret from you guys. You guys can be fully in on my plan, because it's such a long ways off, because I have to be level 46 to do it, I think, and I'm gonna take down the Dark Brotherhood, because I've never done it before, and I think that'll be exciting.
Speak.
Also, I know I don't have to be level 46 to do it. I just want the Blade of Woe to be the best that it can. I may not even necessarily wait all that long. I mean, I'd like to, but I could also just craft and enchant my own gear. We'll see how that goes, how well we're going into smithing and enchanting as time goes on. But I will be still mining up some iron on this character, because we will be going into smithing, but I'll only really... Wow, you're mean. I don't like you. We'll probably really only be going into iron mines, or we'll only be mining iron at least. I won't need the other stuff.
If you wish to hunt with me,
I can make
your feet
gold from
need to
iron.
Be quick and your eyes quicker.
All right, whatever. I have your shield. I don't know what you're talking about.
Ah, good. I've been waiting for this.
I'm going back and forth. Watch him hit me with some spell right when I'm about to take him out too. It's coming. I can sense it. No? All right, he's done. Fantastic. What can you do? It's a cheap enemy, cheap tactics work. People are dumb, I guess, you know? People do things like this all the time. Already used pretty much all of the enchantment on this bow, but I could just make a new enchantment. That'd be sweet. We got some vampire armor here. We might as well throw that on. I mean, let's see what it is in comparison to our armor right now. We got 31 and 7. And we got 34 and 34. I gotta disenchant that. I actually kind of like the armor we got on right now. It looks pretty good, so I'm gonna stick with it for the time being. Although I'll change it up pretty soon here, because obviously I want to succeed. It's just not all that much of an armor rating for that awesome look. And looks are more important than effectiveness to me in this character, at least as far as armor goes. Not so much weapons, but actually to a certain degree weapons. Like, I would never use a mace. Although it would be a better stealth weapon than a sword, I'd imagine, because of the damage. Anyhow, we gotta go up here, because we have to go to the Talos statue, so we can clear our vampirism, hopefully. I didn't wait too long to do that. I would imagine that we could do it, but we'll see. Getting pretty close to level 9. I don't know how far I am into this episode at this point, because I've separated them into a bunch of different little things, but I can't imagine we're too far in, so got quite a ways to go. I won't do any more 45-minute episodes like I did the last one, most likely, unless quests end up working out to be like that. I think that'll be the lowest I'd cut a video, is around 40 minutes, and the longest I'd probably go is hopefully around a minute and an hour and 10 minutes, rather. So let's activate that and see what our active effects are. I forgot about adrenaline rush. Alright, we're good. We should actually activate that instead of unrelenting force. I don't really like unrelenting force all that much. Adrenaline rush is really good for a character that's going to be using combat two-handed, like constant barrage attacks, but I think we can make good use out of it in early assassin mode, just as kind of our last effort once we get detected. It's not like a health regening thing, which would be nice, but whatever.
Some people don't think I'm smart. Those people get my fist. But you, I like.
Thanks. I've taken care of the problem. How flattering, this guy. Jeez.
Another job well done.
Blushing.
Your payment is secure. And you have my thanks.
Awesome. 100 gold, not too bad. I'm looking for work.
Skior was looking for you earlier.
Alright, what does he want?
Don't know. He just said he needed to talk to you before you do anything else. I don't like making him angry, but there is some work for you if you want it.
Yeah, I think I'll just take off and, just leave. Talk to him later.
Pretend you didn't.
Is it not
allowed? There you are.
You wanted to see me.
It's not exactly forbidden, but even so, it's not
true. I did. Your time, it seems, has come.
I'm more curious about their conversation. What do you mean?
Last week, a scholar came to us. He said he knew where we could find another fragment of Wuthrad.
A scholar?
He seemed a fool to me.
I gotta make that build.
If he's right. The honor of the companions demand that we seek it out.
So I'm gonna listen to some of what they say, because it's easier than talking sometimes, but I'm really hungry. I'm just gonna talk over them when I feel like it, unless you guys have any objections, so I'd be honored to retrieve it.
There's a fine line between respect and bootlicking, new blood. But I like your spirit.
You can't win with these guys.
You just can't win. Do well. You'll be counted among the companions. Farkas will be your shield sibling on this venture, Will. He'll answer any questions you have. Try not to disappoint, or to get him killed.
I think it's really sexist that they didn't make husbands for this game. I've never actually gotten a wife in this game, which is something that we should totally do in this Let's Play. gay marriage all the way. Just kidding. I think it'd just be fun to do because I haven't done it. Anyway, I'm not against gay marriage either. I don't know why I say things like that. I just get myself stuck between a rock and a hard place. Anyway, yeah, you going to be my shield brother?
So I'm told. Let's see if you impress.
Anyway, I think you can, I think you can have either male or female, like, not spouses, or, I don't even know. I think you can flirt with both genders in, Fallout before. It may depend on what gender you are. I really don't know. Can you train me to use Betty Harvey? No, I don't. I want to go to this location. All right, so we're gonna travel to the Fort Greymoor first, and I don't think we're gonna take this place out. This may be one that's not dealt with yet, but we're gonna go ahead and do the objective. We'll deal with all this side stuff later. I may just go pretty deep into the companions to start off this let's play. I don't know. Let's see. Leave in the comments, you know. Can always go back to the main quest pretty soon here too, just to get a few more shouts. Wouldn't mind that at all, like become ethereal, and at some point we can get the rest of the become ethereal shouts and the aura whisper shouts and so on. So yeah, pretty pumped for this let's play right now, and I just need to play this game to have fun. It's one of those things where if I'm not playing it, I'm like, I don't really want to play Skyrim because I've played so much, but when I'm playing it, I really enjoy it. So alright, come here, butterfly. Blue butterflies are very valuable in this, if you did not know. I'll get into that in a little bit, but where'd that other butterfly go? I don't care, you're not a valuable butterfly. Anyway, let's get going. I'll invest into alchemy with some of my next perks, but... or with one of my next few perks, I guess, rather. However, right now I want to go ahead and take care of some archery perks that definitely need some dealing with. Because that would be more of... a pertinent, I believe, is a proper word to use here. I don't know what the follow-up word is that I need, but I know pertinent. Anyway, there appear to be some of these guys here. Awesome. No way you detected me that quickly, you mud crab. You silly mud crab, you. I'll take your soul. How about that? Alright, what do you got? Garnet? Ooh, that's pretty good. And it's shitting. I'll take some mud crab legs. I'll restore a little bit of health. Pretty much no health whatsoever, but... I've been actually picking up food in this game because I didn't do that in the past either, but it's one of those things where you're like, shoot, maybe one health is worth it, you know? I mean, it's not, but it could be. Whereas in Fallout 4, food is much more useful because you got one other source of getting health because you don't have restoration or anything, so, you know, I think they balance it out quite well. I'm pretty excited for Elder Scrolls 6, though. I'm kind of disappointed that it wasn't where Fallout 4 was, of course, but Fallout 4 is a ton of fun. It's the first Fallout I've played, and I'm pretty excited for that reason, but other than that, it's not all too exciting. Alright, these guys bailed. I really don't need to kill them that badly anyway. I don't know why we had to be hunting random animals. Maybe it's because we look like a badass hunter and this game's all about killing things, but we'll see. We'll see. I don't know what we'll see means. They took off that way, but I could still get him, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, I thought we'd have to be a little bit higher. Did we get him? Alright, I'm gonna shoot one more arrow. That deer wasn't meant to be killed then. That's my ideology there. I don't know how much you have to adjust the aiming in this, because to a lot of a degree, you don't have to change the aiming in this for most shots, even if they're very far away. But I thought there was a chest here. I guess I was mistaken. We'll head down in here where I know there's a chest in here. It's got like a novice lock on it, but whatever. I really like the lock picking system in Fallout 4, except I don't like it at all. I pretty much didn't go into perks in Fallout 4 when I first started going into it for like the first 20 levels. I just went into special, which was pretty stupid. I got a couple perks, but not too many. I was kind of doing it so that I could have my builds more specialized, but I realized that it doesn't really matter the higher I go in that. We'll cross that bridge when we come to it, but anyway. Yeah, certainly does. Anyway. I like the lockpicking system because they make you get a perk to be able to unlock certain locks. And I didn't really go into it, so that's why I wasn't a huge fan of it. obviously, while I was playing the game, but I really liked the idea behind it. I was just lazy for not going into it because I didn't have proper perk management, but it was the first of those games that I played. Also, I do know that it was a little bit of a different format to the whole special thing than it was in Fallout New Vegas and Fallout 3 and all those games. So I don't know how much of it I would have messed up anyway if I were playing, having played Fallout prior to that. Anyway, I'm really bad at conversating when I'm killing things because I don't even know why. This is a pretty trivial task. But something about it makes you concentrate way too hard. Alright, I think his ancient Nordic bow will actually be better than this hunting bow, like for certain. I'm not for certain about that, but I'm pretty sure. I don't know why I didn't pick one up in the Bleak Falls Barrow prior to this, though, is my only concern about it, although...
Wait, I remember you. So the old man thinks you've got some heart, I guess.
You know this one? I saw her training in the yard with Vilkas.
Let's test that out sometime.
Ah, yes. I think you gave him
word gets around way too quickly here.
Don't let Vilkas catch you saying that.
Do you think you could handle Vilkas in a real fight?
Well, I don't care for boasting.
Huh. A woman who lets her actions speak for her. I knew there was something I liked about you. Here, let's have Farkas show you where you'll be resting your head.
All right.
Farkas.
I like this armor. It looks pretty good. It looks like a Pocahontas type character.
Show this new blood.
Because she looks Indian, not to be racist or anything. I mean, she's a little dark for Native American Indian.
Come on, follow me.
People in the comments, you never know on YouTube. I don't usually have that kind of stuff on my comments sections, thankfully. But as you get bigger, it begins to appear, of course. So we'll see if we get there one day. That's an odd goal to have for a channel, but I'm going to set it as one.
Nice to have a new face around. It gets boring here.
I don't
sometimes.
Even know. This is 9 minutes on top of whatever
here.
I made in
this
iMovie.
This could be a rough life.
It's probably around 10,
the quarters
12
are up
minutes
here.
In somewhere
just pick
in
a
there,
bed
maybe.
And fall
I don't
in
know.
When you're tired. Tell me we'll keep the place.
I want this bed.
I haven't.
I want this bed.
Or
I want this bed.
Have we met?
I want this bed. All right, I can't have any beds.
All
that's
right,
too bad.
Here you are. Looks like the others are eager to meet you.
Do I actually not have a bed at all? That's too
Once
bad,
made
man.
You a bit of a name for yourself. Skjor and Vilkas might have things for you to do.
I think you
Good
have
luck.
To do a couple quests.
Welcome to the
and
companions.
Then you could sleep in any bed, maybe. I don't know.
By the way, if you're looking for something to do, we've got trouble right here in Whiterun Hold. Nothing we can't handle.
Yeah, what kind of trouble should I expect?
Bloodsuckers. Vampires. Take every precaution. One bite and you could end up as one of them.
I'll take care of it.
Good. Do not spare them your blade.
Alright, I'm probably gonna
By
use
the
my
way,
bow, but.
If you're looking for something to do.
What are you talking about? You just gave me something to do. Alright. Broken Fang Cave. Oh, Whiterun Hold. Okay, I was gonna say, why would there be one in Whiterun? And I was kinda curious about that, but no, it's just the whole hold. That's alright, we'll get him. This'll be A-okay, I think. A little easy mission. I don't know, vampires are pretty tough, especially for level 8, but expert difficulty is not too rough. I mean, adept is kind of easy, so. I don't know, Fallout 4 was kind of tough. I played a lot of that game on normal, and I didn't really go up. I played a little bit on easy, even, at some points. I don't think they have an expert, I think they just have, like, a hard, and then, like, the legendary equivalent of whatever Fallout is. I never actually looked at that. Yeah, anyway. I don't know where to go with my train of thought from here. I think we're gonna spend a little bit more time than people would like in like areas where we're gonna be enchanting things and making alchemy potions. I can cut some of that and mining and stuff like that. If you'd like to see it, feel free. I really don't know what to include in this as it is so late. I mean, normally early on you'd kind of cut all that so you can get the exciting stuff in, but now, you know, And then again, you don't want to see the same old stuff over and over, but who knows? Who knows? So feel free to leave that in the comments if you would. I know it's a little bit late in the video to be asking for comment stuff, and I know it's only like 10, 12 minutes out of an hour video, but I don't think all that many people watch all the way through. I'm not entirely sure, though. Most people watch all the way through builds, which I don't see why you wouldn't. But, oh, hello. Got some wolves. I need to get the soul trap enchantment. I actually did. And I put that enchantment on my bow. I forgot about that. Oh my goodness, there's a dragon. Okay, I'm gonna loot this and this. One thing about this character is that I'm not using any restoration. And, I don't know, we'll see what that does for us, but jeez. It's for a role-playing purpose. I think it'll work out alright. Since we're going into alchemy, I just gotta make a few more health potions than I ever have, because I don't make health potions, because I don't make potions, but it's new to it's good to try new things. I would imagine that it would be quite fun to do some of that stuff in this game, since I haven't done it yet, so hopefully it's gonna be what I envisioned it to be. I don't know how much archery we're gonna be doing in third person, because I don't really like third person archery, but we'll see. I'm really hoping that dragon's not still out there when we go out there, because that would be just awful. But we'll see. Alright. There's enemies nearby, so I can't wait in there. I don't know how I'm already detected, though. That's a little precarious. I don't know. I don't think that's the right word. Hopefully I get sneak attacked. Yeah, there we go. Oh, no. Alright. So they're pretty powerful. Pretty healthy. I've contracted that shit, so I'll have to deal with that when I get back to Whiterun. Oh no. I didn't really have many health potions, so I'm concentrating. And I'm not very good at that. We're gonna have to head out. This is a little annoying, I know. I'm sorry, I should cut this, but I'm gonna wait outside and then go back in with health, and, yeah, actually, let's pick this, because why not? We could use some alchemy stuff. I'm imagining that this vampire will have all of its health back, and that's probably not going to change our outcome of this battle at all. I mean, it'll probably be the same as it were before, I guess. I'm trying to say, I really don't know. Yeah, she's got full health again, though. And, shucks. Alright, as long as I keep my distance, she can't really do all that much damage. I mean, she is gaining her health back, which is crap, but if she gets up close, she can destroy me with her blade, so I don't know where to go from here. And I think I should take out the skeleton before he destroys me here, which he kind of started to. There's our first soul. I actually enchanted something already. I think it was a sword that I already got rid of, though, actually, so never mind. I don't know for sure. Oh, come on. I had her, too. Dry mortal. Okay. There she goes. Oh, come on now. Knock that off. Oh, two kill cams that weren't proper kills. That's disappointing. Is she, like, waking this dude up? Yep, waking up the master vampire. This is ridiculous. I'm gonna cut this. Alright, there go a couple of minutes, but this guy's pacing here, and I don't know what I meant by that. That was terribly phrased. But I think I'm gonna get wrecked if I try and attack both of these guys. And, yeah, sneak went up though, so that's good. And, yeah, here's both of these guys. Oh my goodness. Alright, yeah, no. Not at all. If I can just get to her, I think I can take out the guy. Although I don't have any sneak perks yet. I should once I level up here. I'll definitely invest some into there, but I'd like to use the one-handed does 3x sneak attack damage, for instance. That'd be a great help here. And she better not get over here with that blade, because that is a serious threat to my health. This is a good way of leveling, though. I like it. Only like 4 different times I had to wait. And no bad shot. No bad shot. Oh, come on now. That just stinks. I gotta get a shot on her now. Alright, the master should be coming in. And, there she is, maybe? I don't know. Yeah, got her. Awesome. Okay, now, the trick is getting this guy down to, nothing, which I don't see happening. Alright, we got one dead. I'm gonna wait. Alas, to Skyrim! This has gotta be the weirdest Let's Play. Alright, let's, loot this, actually. It's been sitting here for a while. Ooh, we got some decent stuff. I think the entire tone of this battle depends on whether I can get a sneak attack off on this guy, and he should be sleeping in the other room, I'm really hoping. Because that would be very good. I don't think I'm gonna be able to get up close enough to get a one-handed sneak attack off on him. And also, I just don't have the perk, so it wouldn't be all that great anyway. I'm gonna try and shoot him. And see how many shots I can get off before I have to pull out my swords. That sucks, I missed one. Two. Damn it, I'm done. I'm so done. Gun City, alright. I don't know if any of you actually watched that Until Dawn Let's Play, but that was a little reference there that has been stuck in my head for months, and I still use it, like, every day. The Dun City thing, so I don't know. Hopefully I can get this guy. I don't see any manageable way for me to do that at this point, but I could try archery. What do we got? Alright, maybe this is the way we take him out. This is better though. It does do 11 damage, and my weapon does... Oh. What? Okay, I already had one of those. Alright, I did pick it up. And it's just... That's what I enchanted to. It wasn't the sword. That's such a mystery solver. Alright, basically I chose this one even though it's weaker because I bought it and it had Soul Trap. I didn't find it with Soul Trap. That's right. It all comes together now. Alright, let's continue along here. This part is an annoyance because it just wastes time because I've seen it all before, but oh well. Let's grab this and let's do some enchanting, why not, since it's here. What do we got? Let's disenchant. Not the soul snares. Destruction, dwindling, whatever. It is about dead, but my ancient Nordbow, I can get another one in a minute, but it does have an enchantment on it, so there's no real point. I'm gonna enchant my scimitars with some frost damage, and actually I'd like you to just do 1 point of frost damage for a lot of hits. No, 2 points? I don't know. Why not? No. They're petty souls. I'll just have them do like 2 damage. That's a pretty good amount of damage, I'd say. And then this one lasts... Okay, it lasts the same amount. I guess I filled that common soul with a lesser soul. Or the common soul gem with a lesser soul. Anyhow. What else I got in here? I got this that I could put archery on, which would be sweet. Bows do 1% more damage. Yes, of course. What else could I possibly want? You get to see me with putting these wonderful enchantments on my gear. So, actually, you know what? I don't even want light armor. I'll take fortify stamina by 2 points. Yes. Alright, that probably was far less beneficial, but I do what I do sometimes, you know? Let's get fortify stamina, 2 points, what's up? And, for bracers, we could get some archery on those. Sweet, and our last enchantment is going to be one of these necklaces or rings. Let's just go with some more fortify archery, and I'll make sure that that's the one that I'm wearing. When I go into my apparel here. There we go. Awesome. Now, with this level up here, we're almost there, so you know what? I'll go into archery first, but then I'll go into alchemy next. Actually, I want to go into speech, or not speech, into sneak also. So we're going to have to do some perk management. I really want to spread out my perks early game, though. I don't want to be too far invested into one thing. Because I will be going legendary in all of these skills eventually anyway, so I'd like to level them up all at a similar rate. I don't want to just go legendary in one thing 8 times because it's easier that way for whatever reason. You know, it's one of those things. I don't know. We'll see. we shall see. I'd eventually like to set the goal of just getting all
now
the perks and all the trees
into.
That I've set
no
up
worries.
So far.
Just sit tight. I'll find the release.
Of course, with the exceptions of smithing and die, enchanting, eventually I could just return those perks from the Black Book at the end of the Dragonborn DLC, so I get to watch this guy die real quick, and I get to fight the rest of the dungeon on my own after these guys shoot me through the bars, which is nice. No, totally kidding. Obviously, you guys have seen this before, right? I'd imagine. Very hungry, but I'll deal with that in a minute, or I guess like 30 minutes. Probably less. Who knows? I'll check it out a little bit. Those guys were dying before he was even touching them. That's a powerful mofo right there. That just terrified him to death somehow. That's great. Alright. Okay, people are here. I'm gonna cut real quick. Alright.
I didn't scare you.
I just took a good 40 minutes off, but I apologize for that small cut. Anyway, what was that?
It's a blessing given to some of us. We can be like wild beasts. Fearsome.
Badass. Can I be a werewolf?
Oh no. Only the Circle have the beast blood. Prove your honor to be a companion. Eyes on the prey, not the horizon. We should keep moving.
I like that.
Still the Draugr to
worry
about.
Eyes on the prey, but not the horizon. It's very wise. I hope they bring the looting system that they have in Fallout 4 into Elder Scrolls 6, because it's quite good, if I do say so myself. And it's nice to have those cure disease potions on us. I hope to load up on potions in this particular game. This save file, I guess. I don't know. Whatever the case. I think we're coming up on a little bit of an enemy here. One of these guys. It's the other chick, I think. This dude. Yeah, he's got a lot more health. I'm sorry, Farkas. I didn't mean to. I didn't mean to. Stop getting in my way. Yeah, right through the arm. Nice. Farkas's arm, that was. Anyway, take this flawless amethyst and be on my way. I didn't really mention what the Fallout 4 looting system was, and basically what it is it just pops up whenever you go over their body, it just pops up all the items in their inventory, which is quite cool. I like it quite a bit. And, not yet, because I think this is... Oh, yeah, here we go. Autosave, why not? I think there's some trouble a-brewing nearby. But this is the first spot where you can just get some sneak increase to 32 there. There we go. I'm going to go into Alchemy because if I don't do it now, I won't do it later. And I'm going to stop going into health once we get to 200 as well to go into stamina for just a bit. And then I'll go back into health because that's the great thing about an assassin is that you can go into health. Whereas with a mage assassin, I like to just go into magic, because assassins aren't supposed to be detected anyway. Why would you ever get hit? No, early game, it's a very useful thing to have. Alright, I'm glad he didn't hit me. It totally looked like he was gonna. Alright, here we go. Some Horker Loaf, that's probably not worth it in the weight to usefulness ratio, but oh well. Alright. You're done. In 7 arrows from now. These guys are straight up missing me. I'm not even straight. I figured I had a pretty good amount of health. And I didn't want to waste any... Well, I didn't want to mess up my aim on him. And I don't know why that was a sneak attack. That's quite clutch. Yeah, let's see what we got in this chest here. Got some arrows and amethyst and some gold. Not too shabby. I was gonna say not too bad, but, I don't know. Something happened there. Anyway, there's a master lock over here that I wish I could open, but obviously that's not gonna be an option. Let's see what this guy's got, and, 1 second, I just gotta cut real quick. Alright, my apologies for that. That's actually not a bad solution. I was trying to text someone, and then I was gonna be like, hey, you gotta go away, but they don't respond very often anyway, so I could just mini-cut like that, and as long as we're not in combat, it'll be all good. I hope you guys don't mind that. I don't think you would. Doesn't affect you too much. Because I cut, so you know, that's that. Alright, let's see. Here is a really good place to get some extra stealth bonus. There's a nice Draugr dead. and you gotta wait for this eye to go entirely away each time you do it. Otherwise, you won't get the sneak attack bonus. And every time you attack someone, I believe that it is guaranteed that that eye will pop open just from your companion. But I'm not certain. Anyhow, I'm gonna do double armed attacks on the rest of these guys, because I don't know how many of them are just Draugr, and if any of them are Restless Draugr or anything like that. There is a much more threatening enemy right up close to here. However, I think I can take this guy out first. I don't know where they are. Oh, there they are. Alright. I'm just gonna pull out my bow and let Farkas do most of the work. In the past, I've tried to do this on experts, and it hasn't worked out too well. Simply because he just wrecks Farkas like he is right now. And then he comes back to me, and it's pretty evident that I won't be surviving this unless I get some hits off. So we are only on expert though. It didn't do too bad of a chunk of damage there. It usually does a bit more if you're running. But then again, I am used to playing on master. I don't know why I kept saying expert, if that's what I'm saying. Anyway, my apologies there, and let's move on, because that guy was not this guy, and this guy is still alive, so we might as well take out this guy. Fantastic. Alright, let's get into third person so we look cool, and I got to cut real quick. Sorry. Alright, right back, and I'm not certain of where. I was pretty sure that there was some Draugr here, but I guess not. I don't know where that train of thought was exactly going. I kind of started speaking before the thought came into mind. However, it just seemed like there should have been a few more Draugr right there. And, I actually got to cut in a minute here anyway, just to check. I haven't checked how long the episode's been at for a while, but I'll clear out this next area before we do that, because I don't want to excessively do that. I've already done it a couple times in a couple minutes, and that's no good, right? Alright. Let's see what we got. I forgot about the aim.